work very hard. Too hard sometimes. But they love what they do, so it really shows, you know? I think last time, well, when we performed together, they had just flown in and everyone was really jet-lagged, and we were all up super late rehearsing together, and they already knew, yeah, they already knew what they were doing, but they stayed in the rehearsal so that I could get comfortable.
I mean, come on.
I mean, that's what it seemed like.
First time ever for her, like, dancing, and she, like, practiced all the moves. And, you know, she came to Korea for us. You know. We're all friends, right?
She's a good dancer.
Yeah.
Well, that's just a great thing. Making new friends in this business is hard to do, but now you have with BTS, and that's so cool.
It's true. It's very true. I was really sad last time I left them because I didn't think I was going to see them for a long time. So that's why I came here.
Oh, it's a reunion tonight, and you get to see the whole thing. Well, Halsey, thank you so much for coming tonight.
Thank you, guys.
A quick little drop by surprise.
In terms of what I think the role of an institution such as Serpentine or others would be in this moment, I think the opportunity is in something kind of akin to like an embassy model. So this zone where people that are coming from different disciplines, different backgrounds, different professions and industries can kind of convene. And part of that kind of convening process, I think, comes from the brokerage of new types of partnership. So I think the kind of canonical example for us in recent years was the collaboration that we did with the K-pop band BTS. And what was amazing doing that project was that by working with BTS, they were able to extend the work to their audience, and it brought an entirely different group of people that would traditionally come to the Serpentine. But that then produces like very unlikely outcomes. And just, you know, kind of reading the commentary online on Twitter and engaging with various K-pop fans was totally different to any kind of experience that we've had producing an artwork before. And there was a kind of much deeper, richer engagement around the artist, and people were quite comfortable from the K-pop army reaching out to Jakob Kudstensen, who produced the work directly. So I think certainly for us, we do think that it's about finding these kind of uncanny, unlikely alliances between kind of spheres of knowledge and different kinds of practices and across the world in order to produce completely new types of community. And I think that's a kind of exciting future for the institution, I think, not to be kind of just located within its existing community and to only work for, you know, a somewhat undefined general public.
If you were a boy, what would be your name? I've never thought about that. Probably Jungkook. I'd be a Jungkook. Or no, I'd probably be like a Jin. I think I identify my personality with BTS as Jin more because I'm kind of sarcastic, kind of funny, but I still act like the older sister to everyone. In his case, like the older brother of all the maknaes. So yeah, I'd probably be a Jin.